open your mouth and worship. There's nobody great. Nobody great. Nobody greater than you. Nobody great.
Nobody.
Nobody great.
Nobody.
Nobody greater than you. Oh, can we worship for a moment? Nobody great.
Nobody great.
Nobody great.
Nobody great.
Nobody greater than.
Nobody greater than you.
High and low, still couldn't find nobody. Nobody great. Nobody great. Can we just sing this? Because our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are high.
Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God, oh, said our God is greater,
our God is stronger, God, you are higher than any, awesome in power.
Christ is risen, and you know the response to that. He is risen indeed. We praise God for this time of coming together to worship our Lord, to pray unto our Lord. We welcome to this time of prayer. We welcome you to like what we are doing, to also share what we are doing, to comment, respond to Christ is risen. Give us also your I am statement. And why don't you name one thing the Lord has done for you today? And also just subscribe if you're on YouTube, that kind of thing. We are so blessed to have you here today to be a part of this time of prayer. And how blessed we are to be able to pray and have this kind of relationship with God, this intimate, close relationship with God. We can commune with him, and I am excited about that as well. Listen, I'm going to get right into our time of prayer out of our devotional book today, God's Purpose for Your Life, the name of our devotional book. May 11th, the title of the devotional is Submitting the Reins, Submitting the Reins. And it comes out of Psalms, the 31st number of the Psalm, verse 3. And here's what we're going to do. We're going to read this scripture. We're going to walk into our model prayer, you know, the Our Father prayer. And then we will look at the prayer starter here in the book. And today we're praying for our governmental leaders. And sometimes I just want to pray for just leaders, whether it be government, whether it be leaders in the Lord's church, or whether it be leaders in business, or leaders in media, or whatever, in the arts, wherever leadership is, and leadership and even in the home, because leadership is so important, and the right kind of leadership is so, so important. All right, let's read. Psalm, the 31st number of the Psalm says this, verse number 3, it says this, "For you are my rock and my fortress. Therefore, for your name's sake, lead me and guide me." Amen. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us, O God, our trespasses as we forgive those who have trespassed against us. Lead us not, O God, into temptation. And deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Lord, we submit the reins of our lives to you. Make us sensitive, O God, to your promptings so we can obey you and we can obey you completely. Hallelujah. Lord, as we talk about submitting the reins to you, we pray that we have leaders in our government, starting with our president, even down to the council person and the neighborhood association leader. We pray, Lord, that all who give leadership in the nation, in the states, in the cities, in the neighborhoods, Lord, all who give leadership in business, in media, all who give leadership, Lord, even in your church, that we would all be submitted to you. Lord, it is our role to pray for, our responsibility to lift up these leaders, male and female, old and young, red, yellow, black and white, whoever they are. We lift them up to you, God, not just in our country, in America, where I am praying now, but Lord, I pray for leaders all over. I see the turmoil going on in this place, Syria, in this place, Russia, in this place, India, and so on and so forth. And Lord, we lift it up to you. And we know, Lord, a lot of this rises and falls as it relates to leadership. So we lift them up to you, God. Lord, I know some of them have already confessed you as Lord and Savior, and for that we are grateful. Lord, we are praying for those who have done so, to live so, to walk in the ways of the word, to be submitted to your power and your authority, God, to live holy lives. All of us, Lord, as leaders, and then all of us, just mankind, who have submitted themselves to you, God. And Lord, those who have not, we are still praying for them. We're praying for their soul salvation. We're praying for their submission to you, God. And Lord, ultimately, Lord, we know whether they submit or not, you are still in control, God, and we thank you for that. You told us to pray, Lord, that we might live quiet lives and lives of peace, and Lord, in lives of godliness and holiness, God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we pray for our leaders and the laws that they're trying to put forth. We pray that these laws would line up with your laws, would line up with your will, would line up with your desire for mankind and for humanity in the name of Jesus, God. And Lord, I pray even now for our leadership, Lord, that when leadership over us is leading us in the wrong way, we'll have the courage and the boldness to stand strong, like those three Hebrew boys, like Daniel, like John, like so many others, Lord, who stood strong, like Jeremiah, in the face of persecution, when folk didn't want to hear the truth, they stood strong, even at the risk of their own lives and death. They stood strong, Father, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we lift all of these leaders up to you, every place, everywhere, every leader. And we know, God, that you can move them and steer them in the direction that you choose. Bless the nation whose God is the Lord. Lord, we bless your name, and we thank you for those who are praying with me now online. Walk with them, be with them, strengthen them, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah. And amen. God bless you, saints. Thank you so much for hanging out with me in prayer. Listen, hopefully we'll see you tomorrow for lunch with the Lord at 12 noon, if it is the Lord's will. And then Thursday, of course, and Friday for our time of prayer again at 12 noon. Hey, I love you with the love of the Lord. Hugs and kisses to you all. God bless you. Bye-bye.
Makes no difference what you're going through. You're gonna make it. God's gonna see you through. Hold your head up. Put a smile on your face. This is another test. He won't last always. So get ready.
Get ready
for your blessing. You, it's gonna be alright. Troubles and trials come to make you strong. Keep on believing. You keep holding on.
Everybody say that with me.
God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
If you really believe it,
God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
Come on.
God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Come on. God's got a blessing.
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 With your name on it.
With your name on it.
God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
Say, God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
Yeah.